those that we join. We thank you for those who are watching on Periscope. We thank you for the opportunity of prayer, opportunity to come to you. You say, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Thank you for deliverances. Thank you for your manifestation. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your anointing. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your kindness. Thank you for your power. The Bible says a child will be born, a son will be given, and the government of the world will be upon his shoulder. His name shall be Wonderful. Thank you for being wonderful to us. Your name shall be the Counselor. Thank you for counseling us. You are the Almighty God. Thank you for being the Sovereign God, the God that ruleth over the nations. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The Bible says your name will be the Everlasting Father. You have been our Father, the great provider, the great protector, the great caretaker. Blessed be your name. The Bible says you are the husbandman. You are the gardener. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. The Bible says you are the Prince of Peace. Thank you for being our peace, the motivator, the encourager of our peace, the pilot of our peace. We give you praise, O God, in the name of the Lord Jesus. Thank you since the beginning of the year. You have not allowed calamity. You have not allowed evil. You have not allowed catastrophe to be our portion. It is not our power. It is not by our mind. It is because we are good. We have challenges. We have things we are believing you, God, for. But we thank you because, Lord Jesus, you are able to do it. And that's why we are confident in coming again tonight. That, Lord, tonight again, we will see you as never before. We will witness you in a new dimension. We will experience you in a monumental way. The enemy will bow again tonight. The name of the Lord will be glorified tonight. The name of the Lord will be lifted up tonight. Thank you, our Father, Lord. Let everyone that will partake on this table, let everyone that we eat of your menu tonight, let their life be, Lord, blessed. Let their career be blessed. Let their life witness, Lord Jesus, power to move on, power to succeed in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. The word that comes to my spirit tonight that I want us to share and pray upon is what I call pressing on, pressing on. And I'm going to take a text from a well-known passage, you know, where Paul spoke about pressing on, pressing on. Let's read our Bibles. Please put up your Bible, now iPhone, iPad, smartphone, you know. I watch a video clip recently that was, you know, the man carried the iPhone and then carried the Bible and said, I recommend the Bible for you. Because with the Bible, you don't have temptations. You don't have interruptions. You have revelations. You know, when you want to use the iPhone Bible, then somebody will send a text, somebody will send a WhatsApp message, somebody will, you know, something will come up that even at times you find that you are reading something, a call comes in, it blocks out everything. So I always recommend that as much as technology is good, let's maintain our Bible. Hallelujah. Okay, Philippians chapter 3. We are going to verse 14, but let's read from verse 10. I like verse 10 also. He said, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering, being made conformable unto his death. You know, I noticed that most times when we read this scripture, we only limit ourselves to the A part, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his suffering. We are silent on that, you know, and we are more silent on being made conformable unto his death. But this is a total package. Amen. Knowing God is being conformed to his image. Knowing God is having the best of him, but in having the best of him, you go through some process. This process is at times may be hard. and we call it suffering. And the Bible calls even the fruit of the Spirit long-suffering. But it says being made conformable unto his death. We have to know this God to the point that we are willing to suffer to the point of death. And the Lord God will watch over us in Jesus' name. As I said, let's go forward. Verse 11. If by any means I might attain unto the resurrection of the dead. If we want to resurrect, we want to die first before we resurrect. That's what Paul is saying. Not as though I had already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend that for which also I am apprehended of Christ Jesus. Brethren, I cannot myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before. I press. Somebody say, I press. I press toward the mark of the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Pressing forward. Pressing forward. I want to speak to you tonight about pressing forward. Pressing forward. The matter of life, the matter of Christ, the matter of our calling is about pressing forward. There is need for us to press forward. Children of God, there is need for you to press forward. If there is no need for you to press forward, it won't be in the Bible. And when you look at the life of the writer, which is Paul, you will know that he knows what he's talking about when he's talking about pressing forward. Why must he press forward? Because since Jesus called him in Acts chapter 9, he told him from day one. You know, you see, he said in that Philippians 3 verse 10, he said that I may know him and the fellowship of his suffering. He knows what he's talking about. Because let's read Acts chapter 9. You will see that his assignment and responsibility was defined as suffering for Christ. Hallelujah. Look at verse 15. Verse 13, Acts chapter 9. He said, then Ananias answered, Lord, I've heard by many of this man how much evil he has done to the saints at Jerusalem. And here he has authority from the chief priest to bind all that call on thy name. But the Lord said unto him, go thy way, for he is a chosen vessel unto me to bear my name before the Gentiles and kings and the children of Israel. For I will show him how great things he must suffer for my name's sake. So, when he's talking about knowing God and his suffering, he knows what he's talking about. You know, the need for us to talk about pressing forward is because we are in a generation of Christianity that is microwave based. We are in a generation that we have been so pampered that we believe that, look, if it's not working, then back out. Some people will go to marriage. If it doesn't work, back out. It's a trial by error. No, the Bible never gave you that kind of opportunity. No window of opportunity. All I know, the Bible says, read it through and through, is no divorce. Keep on pressing on. In your work, keep on pressing on. So, Paul was encouraging us in this place, you know, that there is a need for us to press forward. How do we press forward? What are the things that he's talking about? Number one, verse 12, it's not as though I had already attained. The reason why you and I must press forward is because you have not attained. I don't know the level of what you have done tonight that you will think you have attained and that you don't need to move forward. I've read this Bible. I see, you know, Elijah raising the dead. I've seen Elisha raising the dead. I don't know how many you have raised. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We have heard about people like Smith Wigwam raising 14 dead people and so on and so forth. Yet, they didn't stop. They kept moving forward. I don't know how many souls who have won to the Lord. Maybe thousands. But we have seen people winning millions of people to the Lord. So, why are you going to stop? That's why he said, not as though I had already attained. He was the one that God used to go on first missionary trip, second missionary trip, and third missionary trip. By the grace of God, from tomorrow we'll be going on another missionary trip to the glory of God. You know, the International Gathering of Eagles, the new the leadership training, will be going to Singapore from tomorrow, going to Thailand, you know, and we are going to pray about it tonight, because these are Islamic strongholds, Philippines, South Korea, China, and so on and so forth. You know, pressing forward. There is need for you to press forward. But maybe your own is not, Pastor, I thank God for your life, but where I need to press forward is the matters of my life, which is good. Identify it. That's my message tonight. Identify where you want to give up, and I'm encouraging you, based on the word of God, that you need to move forward. Is it your academics that you are lacking and you are finding it very, very challenging? Very, very challenging, because the things are not just working well. The marks are not, you know, are not getting there. You're not getting your grades. Your grades are lower than what you wanted. You know, my sister, my brother, my son, my daughter, whatever you are, I want you to know that you can press forward to the mark. When you press forward to the mark, God will help you. The reason you need to press forward is, number one, you need to attain. There is a level God intends for you in life. And until you get to that level, you don't stop. 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 You keep going. You keep going. You keep going. There is always the story of John Rockefeller. You know, he was the Bill Gates of his time. And he kept making money, and he was very prudent. He became millionaire at the age of 31, or billionaire, sorry, you know. And they asked him, why are you still making money? He said, because I need the next dollar, you know. Maybe it is you also want to sponsor the gospel, and all you are doing now is suffering from even inability to give offerings in church. You need to attain. You need to attain a level where you are financially free, where you are financially able, you know, to send your children to school, to have your own house, have your own car, to be able to sponsor the gospel of Jesus. You need to attain. You need to attain. Why must you move forward? Why must you attain? Because God's plan for you is to attain. Maybe your own is about winning souls for Christ, and you have not never done that one. The year is going to an end. This is the month of September. You must ask yourself, how many souls have I won for the Lord this year? Am I just eating on God's table? You must attain that level. You must attain that opportunity. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. Let's move forward. Either we're already perfect. You see, it says not just attaining your desire, your dreams, your aspirations, your ambitions. That is the motivation for pressing forward. He said there is also the need for perfection. When he's talking about perfection, he's not talking about your job. He's not talking about your career. He's talking about your what? He's talking about your character. He's talking about my character. He's talking about my integrity. He's talking about my holiness. How am I living? The Bible says, you know, that we must be perfect as our Father in heaven is perfect. Some people will tell you that, look, this is not the age for that. No, I used to be in that category way back in 1975. You know, I will be arguing with people. Even the Bible says the righteousness of our righteous is what? It's filthy rag. How can you be talking about being perfect? It is the level of your understanding. It is the level of your understanding. You know, the truth is that you can live a perfect life. The Bible says, 1 John chapter 3, verse 7, it says, little children, let me tell you. Let's read it. I want to quote it correctly. Hallelujah. It says, let's not deceive ourselves. It says, if you are righteous, you are righteous. If you are not, you are not. And if you are righteous, then that's what God wants you to do. Hallelujah. Let's look at 1 John 3. 1 John 3, little children, verse 7, let no man deceive you. He that dwells righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. I pray that God will make you perfect in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let's move forward a little bit more. You know, Hallelujah. But I follow after that I may apprehend that for which also I am apprehended of my brethren. I cannot myself to apprehend it. How do we press forward? Don't behave as if you have reached the place. Don't behave as if you know it all. Maybe you are praying for 30 minutes. That's not enough. Don't behave as if that is enough. Maybe you are giving your tithe of $2,000. Thank God for your life. But that's it. Don't behave as if you have attained. Don't behave like that way. Hallelujah. That is how to press forward. Hallelujah. The next one, it says, forgetting those things which are behind. Whether they are good, whether they are bad, there are things you need to forget for you to move forward. Why must you forget them? I listened to one of the man they call the Bible, Walking Bible, Adigboye, the other day. Say, you must forget because there is nothing you can do about it. If you stole 10 years ago and now you are now a Christian, what are you going to do about that one? You committed adultery, you committed fornication 10 years ago. There is nothing you can do about that one. You have been forgiven. So don't condemn yourself. Move forward. You committed abortion. Thank God, it's not the best of life, but that's not what you should now hold on to. That will not allow you to move forward. I want to encourage you tonight, press forward. Press forward in the race of life. Press forward in your career. Press forward in your academics. Don't let your past haunt you. Don't let your past be a destabilizing factor to your progress. No, the windshield is always greater than the what? Than the side mirror. Look at the windshield. It's necessary to look at the side mirror, but you are not controlled. You are not using the side mirror to move forward. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And reaching forth unto those things which are before. What are the things before you tonight? That's what we want to pray about. Do you want to become a medical doctor? Do you want God to give you children? Do you want to raise children? Do you want to be a financier for the gospel? He says so that we can become what God wants us to become. Let me begin to magnify God. My prayer for you tonight is that you will become what God wants you to become. For to become what God wants you to become, you need to press forward. You must not give up. You must not give up. I said the story several times, but I don't have time for that tonight. You know, but the thing is that a quitter never wins. And a winner never quits. A quitter never wins, and a winner never quits. You will not quit. You are not a quitter, you are a winner. Let's begin to praise God. My Father, my God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for tonight. I thank you for the opportunity to come on this prayer line. I magnify you, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for the miracle you have given us earlier. Thank you for the miracle we are still going to have. I give you all the praise. I give you all the honor. I give you all the adoration. In Jesus' name we are praying. Thank God for what you have attained. It's not by your power or by your mind. You pass secondary school. You pass a university. You secure a job. God gave you a husband. Now you are now a grandfather like myself. It's not because you know how to do it. It is the favor of God. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I just want to thank you tonight for what you have done for me. I want to appreciate you, Lord, in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for the progress. I appreciate God for the progress in your life. I appreciate God for the mercy of God concerning your life. Thank God for your business. Thank God for your husband. Thank God for your wife. Thank God for your career. Thank God for your pastor. What is it that you are doing in the church? Thank God for giving you eyes. Thank God for giving you legs to walk. Thank God for that job you are believing God for. Thank God for the one you have right now. Thank God for helping you to pay your mortgage, for helping you to pay your rent, for helping you to pay your insurance premium. Thank God, thank God, thank God. Blessed be your name, O God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we are praying. I want you to pray with me tonight, Lord. Let me know you, Lord. Paul said that I may know you. I may know you. Lord, let me know you. We are in a generation that doesn't care about knowing God. They want to know men. They want connection. They want this one. But God, the author of our life, God, the one that we need to know, we care less about it. That's why we go late to church. That's why we pray less. That's why we don't read the Bible. But we want to pray from tonight. That is the way to press on. That's the way to press on, my sister. Let me know you, Father. Let us pray. Let us pray. My Father, Lord, I pray tonight. Help me to know you more. Help me to know you more. Help me to know you more. Reveal yourself to me. Reveal yourself to me in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. That is where your prosperity is. Mashakuria baboza. Yekerebo sokuriba kula sikiria. Makiribo shenda. In Jesus' name we are praying. You know, one of the words that Lord spoke to Joshua is that this book of the law shall not depart from you. In it we meditate day and night, and we observe to do what is there. And I will make your way prosperous, and I will give you good success. I just pray one more time. Lord, reveal yourself to me. Reveal yourself to me. Help me to know you, Lord. When you know God, your life will be different. When you know God, everything will be easy for you. When you know God is your Father, He will guide you. You will not be in the bush. You will not be wandering. You will not be a layabout. You will be successful. Your way will be prosperous. Good success will be yours. Lord, reveal yourself to me. I want to press on to know you more, Lord. Let my husband, let my wife, let my children, let my pastor, let my friend, let my child pray tonight that we will know this God more. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Landa kasando robo shoria. Yeke rebo soko riba kuria. In Jesus' name we are praying. Let's also pray tonight that, Lord, I may know you with the fellowship of your suffering. You know, there is something about this Christianity that is not making us to press for. We don't want to encounter anything. We want it too easy. Even Jesus Christ, when he came here, it wasn't easy. Amen? So who do we want to resemble? He said, if they hated me, they will hate you. He was in the boat. He was getting tired. Let's ask God, Lord, help me to endure suffering for your gospel. Help me to endure suffering for your gospel. Help me. If you don't know how to endure suffering, it will be difficult for you to share the gospel. It will be any little thing, even in your marriage, you say, I'm getting out, I'm getting out. Why must you get out? Why must you get out? Why must you not endure? Why must you give up? There is something called suffering. There is something called patience. There is something called long suffering. Ask God to give you the grace to follow through in the line of grace, of long suffering, in the line of patience. Pressing on tonight. Help me to press on. Help me to know what suffering is and to endure it in the name of Lord Jesus. Let me not shy away. The path of life is not rosy. There is a process in everything we do in life. My God, help me, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. He said, be made conformable unto his death. Lord, even death, let it not be a challenge for me. When you die, all of us will die. When I leave this place, Lord, let it not be a thing of trouble for me. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ. When you have conformed with God, when you have known God, death will not be a thing for you. Christians must be prepared to lay their lives down for the gospel. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only life unto us, his own son to us, who died for us on the cross of Calvary. That's John 3:16. 1 John 3:16, hereby perceive we the love of God, that if he lay down his life, we also have to. Lord, help me to lay down my life for the brethren. That is how to press forward. That is how to press forward. Building a character. Building the great material, great stuff to your life. You can't tell a child that because of rain, don't go to school. Because of rain, don't go to farm. Because of snow, don't go to work. No. It is suffering, but you have to endure it because there is something before. There is something you want to attain. Let me press forward, Lord. Let me not look at what is going on. Help me to press forward in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we are praying. You know, the Yoruba men have an adage. They say, whoever will take the honey in the rock will not look at the mouth of the what? At the axe. There is the axe you are using. Car to break the rock because you see that there is honey there. Many of us, we are so conscious about the axe than the honey we are looking to. Jesus is honey for you. Amen. I say Jesus is honey for you. There is honey in Christ. There is a blessing in Christ. There is a breakthrough in Christ. Until you press forward towards it. until you go to school, you pass the exam, you don't get job for and get a remuneration, you know, based on that position. No, when you go through the mill, when you pass that exam, then you can say, look, now you can give me $50 per hour. You can give me $100 per hour. You must go through the mill. Lord Jesus, help me. Help me to press forward. Help me to press on tonight. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, I'm tired of shaking out. I'm tired of wasting away. I'm tired of fearing. I'm tired of all kinds of things that does not allow me to get to where I need to go to. My God, I want to move forward in you. I want to move forward in you. I want to move forward in you. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Amen. Let's look at Deuteronomy chapter 3, verse 19. Deuteronomy chapter 3, verse 19. There is a word for us to confess there tonight. Hallelujah. He said, but your wives and your cattle, the little ones, and for I know that, but your wives and your little ones and your cattle, for I know that ye have much cattle, shall abide in your cities which I have given you. The Lord is talking about abiding. He's talking about blessing. He's talking about releasing prosperity. He's talking about the when you endure, what will get the juice that I'm talking about. Your house will be normal. Everything around you will be normal. Say, Lord Jesus, as I press on, Lord Jesus Christ, let my wife abide. Let my children abide. Let everything abide for me. Let everything be prosperous for me. Let us pray. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lakamboso kurobobo shiria. The blessing of working for you, the blessing of staying true, let it be my portion tonight. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Makashande lekerebo soko robo zoria bashida lekoske rebo zoria. Lord, I pray tonight that help shall come to me. Help, help, help from above. 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 In Jesus' name, we are praying. Look at 32, Jeremiah 32, Jeremiah 32, verse 27. The blessings are coming. Behold, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me? What is it that you have been pressing forward to, that you have not achieved? God says, is there anything too hard for me? Why don't you say, Lord, I take it tonight. I take it tonight. I want to attain. I want to succeed. I want that breakthrough. Let's pray tonight. Ask God for a breakthrough in your life. Ask God for a breakthrough in your life. Pressing through is about breaking through. Pressing through is about enduring what needs to be endured so that you can have breakthrough. And God says, there is nothing too hard for me. There is nothing too hard for me. What is it you are facing tonight? What is the challenge of your life? Ask God, Lord, give me a breakthrough. Pray, pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, give me a breakthrough. There is nothing difficult for you. Lord, nothing difficult for you. Maybe you have reached a breaking point. The suffering is too much for you. You say, Pastor Dada, you don't know. I've been in this matter for many years. Ask God for breakthrough tonight. There is success for you. Rababobo shokorobo shulia. Yeke seke rebo soko ribaka. Maleke rebo sokuria. Rabolo sondo robo she. Mozuria bakuria. Lord, help me tonight. In the name of the Lord. There is nothing difficult for our God. Bring it to Jesus. Bring it to him tonight. 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 Holy Spirit, help me. Holy Spirit, help me. That breakthrough. What is it that has been eluding you because you didn't press through? Many of us cannot pray through. Ask God, let me pray through. I want pray through tonight. Pray through tonight. Press on in prayer. 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 Many of us get so shaking us for too early. Too early. Rababo shoko robobo shuria. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. I don't know how many of you that read Growing Rich by Napoleon Hill. He talked about how a man went to California and he was digging. He was told that there is a mineral resource there, whether it's diamond or gold, I can't remember, you know, and he dug and dug and dug, and When he couldn't get what he wanted, he left that place, sold it cheaply, and left. The other man bought it. He had hardly dug anything when he got the minerals there. The minerals were there, but he's shaking out. You will not shaken out in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray tonight. My breakthrough, let me press to it. Let me dig to that point. Let me dig to the point of my success. I have suffered enough. The spirit of backing out, the spirit that makes me to, they call it failure at the point of success. It is not your portion. It is not my portion. I need somebody to pray tonight. Lord, every spirit of failure at the point of success, I reject you. I renounce you in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes. The title of the book is Think and Grow Rich. By Napoleon. I recommend it for you. I'm tired of backing out so soon. I'm tired of failure. Failure is not your portion. Leko soko robo bobo sheka. Maleke rebo sokoria. Malia bol. Leke sekende rebo soria. Lord, come and help me tonight in the name of Lord Jesus. Help me tonight. Help me tonight. Help me tonight in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Look at the word of God. Look at the word of God in 1 Samuel chapter 30 verse 8. He said, and David inquired the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I overtake them? And he answered him, pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail recover all. I prophesy to somebody tonight, as you pursue, you will overtake. As you overtake, you will recover all. As you pursue, you will overtake. As you overtake, you will recover all. What is it that has eluded you? Lord, give me grace to pursue. Give me grace to pursue. Give me to pray school. Give me grace to finish that exam. Give me grace to do that business and do well. Shall we pray tonight? Shall we pray tonight? Don't give up. It's the word of God to you tonight. Press on. Press on. Press on. David, press on. David, pursue. David, overtook. David, recover all. You will recover all. You will recover all. Rababo soko robo shoria. Maleke rebo soko riba kura sila. Leke seke rebo bobo shoria. Yeke seke rebo bo. Maleke rebo soko ria. Let me recover all tonight. Let me recover all. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Let me recover all. 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 What is it that I've lost? Pray. Ask God to help you to recover all. Help me to recover all. Recover the years. Shakolabo Shakoria. In Jesus' name we are praying. You know, we just finished the International Garden of Eagles Conference, and the theme is redeeming the times. And we explained that deem, D-E-E-M, means own. So to redeem is to re-own, to repossess, to buy back, to recontrol. I want you to say, Lord Jesus Christ, whatever I have lost, help me to redeem it. Let me buy back my life. The years I have wasted, the year the locusts have eaten, the caterpillar, the palmer worm, help me to buy it back. Help me to redeem the time. Shall we pray tonight? Let's pray, my sister. Let's pray, my brother. You will redeem your life. You will redeem your home. That situation is not beyond God. That situation is not beyond our matter. Lord, I repossess my life. I repossess my life. I repossess my destiny. In the name of Lord Jesus, I repossess it. I repossess it. I repossess it. I repossess my life. Yes, yes. No matter the attack of your life. Shakora bo sokoria bashila. Yekese kerebo sokorobo boshoria. Mosoko riba boshekoria. You can buy your life back. You can buy your life back. You can buy your life back. Rababobo so yekese kerebo soria. I repossess my life. I repossess my life in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Robo so koria baba. Yeke seke rebo. Shande rebo bobo. Leke rebo bo soria bash. Masinde rebo koria. I repossess my life. I repossess my life. I repossess my life in the mighty name of Jesus. I recontrol my life in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. My life will no more be wasted in the name of Jesus. Reke bo sakora boske rebo bo soria. Mamosa kede borobo shekeria. I repossess my life in the name of Jesus. I repossess my life in the name of Jesus. Oh, shakandelebobo shoria. In Jesus' name we are praying. How do we press on? Look at Psalm 107. You know, I like Psalm 107. When you have time, go and read it. Psalm 107 talks about many scenarios. Scenarios where people were on the sea and they were having trouble and they cried to God. Scenario where people were doing business and they are having trouble and they cried to God. Scenario where they were having challenges in one area or the other and they cried to God. But let's just take one of them. Let's take one of them. Look at verse 13. Psalm 107. It said, then they cried unto the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them out of their distresses. He brought them out of darkness and the shadow of death, and break their bands in sunder. Oh, that men will praise the Lord for his goodness and for his mercy, for wonderful works to the children of men. For he has broken the gates of brass and cut the bars of iron asunder. I want you to speak to the gates of brass. I want you to speak to the bars of iron that does not allow you to break through. Oh, God of Bethel, I come to you tonight. Every gates of brass, every bars of iron, denying me breakthrough, that does not allow me to press through, that does not allow me to attain, that does not allow me to succeed, that does not allow me to make it in this land of the living. Tonight I cut the bars of iron. I break the gates of brass. Begin to pray tonight. Do like Samson. They said they lock him up. He carried your gates. He carried your gate. Not just the padlock. Pray through. Pray through. Rabo Shekoriaba. Maleke Rebo Shokoria. I cut the bars of iron. I remove the gates of brass. Every obstacle. That's what they call. He cried unto the Lord. He cried unto the Lord. He cried unto the Lord. And he saved them from their trouble. Save me from trouble. In the name of Jesus. Is it marital trouble? Is it children trouble? Is it career trouble? Is it professional trouble? Is it ministerial trouble? What is hindering your life? Lord, pray through tonight. Help me to pray through. In the name of Lord Jesus. Robo sheke rebo sokalia. Mama mo sheke de. Yeke sike riba kuri basike poria. Remove. Barrier. Remove. Hindrance. Remove. Difficulty. Remove. Limitation. Remove. Be removed by fire. Be removed by fire. In Jesus' name we are praying. I want you to pray from that verse 13 again. He said, then they cried. Somebody said they cried. They cried unto who? Unto the Lord in their trouble. And he saved them out of their distresses. I have good news for you tonight. As you cry to the Lord in your trouble, he will save you from your distresses. He will save you in this year. He will save you from your distresses, from the challenges. But it gives a condition. One of the conditions to press through, to break through, is to call on God. Ask and you shall receive. Seek and you shall find. Knock and shall be opened unto you. Cry tonight. The Bible says in Exodus chapter 2, verse 23, he said, and the children of Israel cry for their reason of bondage. He said, and God had them and had recourse unto them, and he set them free. Begin to pray tonight. Every trouble. I don't know the trouble you are facing. You know the trouble you are facing. You go to church, I come to church, and nothing is happening in your life. No, in the name of Jesus. Yeah, caution. Is it health challenges? Ask God, give me a breakthrough tonight. Let this sickness go. Let this cancer go. Let this attack go. Let this lack of marriage go. Let this barrenness go. Let this distrust go. Let this frustration go. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Rababo Soko Robo Shuria. Maleke Rebo Sokoria. Go. In the name of Jesus. Everything the enemy is using to hold me down, you can't hold me down. I belong to Jesus. Jesus. He's my Lord. He's my Savior. 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 Back out by fire. 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 O rababo shokorobo shoria. Yeke rebo shokoria. Yeke seke riba bosha. In Jesus' name we are praying. I want you to stand wherever you are and begin to say, every pursuer of my life, every tormentor of my life, every harasser of my life, let the fire of the Lord consume you tonight. Those who said I will not succeed, those who said I will be a wanderer, those who said my life will be wasted, I command the fire of God against you tonight in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Chikapola Boskiri. Rekebosokoria. Those who say you will not be other children. Those who say your children will not accept. Those who say they will not allow your children to have your to have their children. Those who say that you will be a failure all your life. I'm not a failure. When I have the God of success, how can you be a failure? When you have the God of success, Rabash, I press forward tonight. Press forward in prayer. I urge you in the name of Jesus. Press forward in this prayer. Yeke seke rebo soria. Yeke seke rebo boshoria. Mosheke rebo boshoria. Yeke seke riba bosha. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. Now I was sharing with a lady this morning about somebody who came to me. This was in a diabolical fire. And I want you to pray because that God can do more. He said this man wanted to follow God. He was walking in a wharf back in Nigeria, and they brought something to him to sign. He said, "This is not correct. We can't do this. This is corruption. I can't be part of this." They said, "Is it your money? Are you the government? It's either you sign it or we kill you." Ah. And then he went home. By the time he came the following morning, he saw on his table a pigeon. They put a rope on the pigeon and put a label, R.I.P. He said he didn't know. I mean, this is an office he locked before he left. He didn't know how a living thing got to that place. And they tied something. This man went to meet Babalawo, and the Babalawo told him, in 21 days, all these people will be dead. In 21 days. And they were coming to work, the four of them who were gathering against this man, and they ran amok. We are not going to Babalawo tonight. We have a God who says in Romans chapter 12, that vengeance belongs to me. Who are those who are sending pigeon to you? Who are those appearing to you in your dream? Who are those who have made up their mind that if you continue to follow this, your God, if you continue to say, I will know God, I will suffer for God, I will pray for God, and you will not amount to anything. Ask God to waste them tonight. Shall we begin to pray? Ask God to waste them. Those who say your life will not amount to anything. Those who said there is no way for you. Masha Korea. Yeke seke rebo so korea babo. Masoko. Yeke seke riabo. Yes, Lord. Those who said they will waste my life, Lord, waste them. Waste them. Waste them. Waste them. Waste them. Waste them in the name of Jesus. Waste them in the name of Jesus Christ. You are the owner of my life. If Babalago can do things and fight for his own people, how much more the God of all things, the God of all flesh, fight for me? Fight for my children. Fight for my destiny. Fight for me, oh God. In the name of Lord Jesus. Yekoso Korea. They said their church will come down. They said your children will fail. They said your marriage will collapse. They said there is no way for you. It's a lie. The gods that have not made the heavens, they shall perish. Mashakorobobo Shoria. Yekeseke rebobo Shoria. Yeboso. Malasikeria babobo Sheka. Yekerebobo so. Rekebo Sakuriaba, Leke Rebo Bobo Shendala Bakuria, Rabo Seke, Maleke Rebo Soko Robo Boshuria, Yeke Sekeria Babo, Sakande Rebo Boshindala Bakuria, Rekebo Sokoria Babo, Lende Rebo, Rikebo Sondo Robo Boshed, Yeke Rebo Bobo Shekaria, Mosokoria Babo Boshed. Yeke seke rebo bobo shuria. Mosa kandara bakuri baba shinda. Mosa koria baba bashinda baba koria. Yeke rebo bobo shokuria baba shinda. Yeke rebo bobo shenda baba koria. Ola kuria basar. Maseke rebo bobo shuria. Mozoko rebo soko robo bobo shuria. Yeke rebo bobo shekalia. Mosoko robo bobo shenda. Yeke rebo bobo shenda. Yeke seka, la bo seke rebo bo sheka. Yeke rebo bo shuria. Yeke rebo bo shenda la bakuria. Rabo rebo sheke rebo bo shuria. Yeke rebo bo shaka. Masa, mosoko rebo bo sheka. Reke po sakuria. Masoko rebo bo shenda. Yeke seke rebo bo mosoko rebo bo shenda. Yes, Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we are praying. Amen. We take one more prayer and then we take testimonies and prayer points, but go to Isaiah 45 verse 19. He said, I have not spoken in secret in the dark place of the earth. I said not unto the seed of Jacob, seek ye me in vain. I, the Lord, speak righteousness. I declare things that are right. I want you to pray tonight. Lord, I will not serve you in vain. You will not serve God in vain. You will not serve God in vain. He said, I have not called the children of Israel. He said, I have not spoken in secret. Many that are making it clear to everybody to hear. In the dark place of the earth, I said not unto the seed of Jacob, seek ye me. You are a spiritual Israelite. You are the generation of Abraham. You are the generation of Jesus Christ. I shall not serve God in vain. I shall not serve God in vain. My breakthrough is guaranteed. I shall break through. In the year 2016, I shall break through. In the month of September, I shall break through. Favor is my portion. Favor is my portion. In this Canada, in this America, in this Nigeria, in this Europe, wherever you are, I shall not serve God in vain. I shall not serve God in vain. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Morababobo sokoria bashida. Yeke shende rebo shuria. Thank you, our God. In Jesus' name we are praying. I prophesy to you tonight, as you press on, you will not serve God in vain. In Jesus' name we are praying. Any praise points or prayer points quickly before we close tonight? Thank you for coming. God bless you. Yes? Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Two Mondays ago, we prayed concerning my daughter.
Yeah.
Who was pregnant.
Yes.
Thank God she gave birth to a baby boy on Friday, the 23rd of September.
Woo! Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen and amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. We use that woman as a point of contact. For everyone that is on this line, trusting God for conception, trusting God for life partner, trusting God for breakthrough in one area, God who gave that child a breakthrough, God who gave, he said in Luke chapter 1 verse 14, he said, he gives us children for gladness and for joy. God who gave that woman gladness and joy, we give you gladness and joy. Let's thank God for that child. Let's thank God. Let's prophesy to that baby that that baby will continue to grow in the counsel of God and use that child as a point of contact for all your people, all your friends that are believing God for similar miracle in the name of Jesus. Maybe they are pregnant and they need to deliver. They are coming with testimony. They are coming with testimony. It's your turn. Next week is your turn for testimony. In the name of Lord Jesus. Urababobo soko riabashanda. Yeke rebo soko riba kula sila. Lakende rebo soko riabashuria. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, our God. In Jesus' name we are praying. I want us to pray for the nations, for our friends and people who are having a desire for children, desire for success in one area of their lives, let's pray. Please, let's go. Maybe some paper, maybe a paper to stay in their country. Maybe they are believing God for job. They are believing God for children. Let's ask God, make a way for them. God, make a way for them. 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 In the name of Lord Jesus. Make a way for them. In the name of Lord Jesus. Let's remember those who are in the hospital tonight, that God will heal them. That God will save them. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we are praying. By the grace of God, we'll be taking the International Garden of Eagles to another level, as from tomorrow, to the glory of God. We'll be going to China, Singapore, Thailand, and many of these nations. I want you to pray with me that God will go with me, that there will be miracles, there will be signs and wonders, that territorial demons will bow. Shall we begin to pray? Uncommon miracles, uncommon miracles, uncommon miracles. Let the borders be open. Let the gates be open. The Bible says, let the ancient gates be open. Let God manifest himself. Yeko so kuria bashanda, mosa kuria bashakanda, lekos kerebo so kuria, ribabusa kuria ba, lekos so koro bobo shenda la bakuria, yeke se kerebo bo so karaba. Let God open doors. Dust. Uncommon miracles. Begin to do it, Lord. In Jesus' name we are praying. As we are praying tonight, Hillary Clinton and Trump are debating. Let's ask, pray for America. Lord, give them the best. Give them the best. The one that will fulfill your counsel. Not just rhetorics, Lord. We are not going to look. The Bible says he sent, what's his name? Samuel. He said he sent Samuel to what? To the house of Jesse. To go and appoint what? A king. When he got there, what did he meet? He met Eliab. He met Shamnah. He met Abnadab. All the big, hefty, you know, king-looking people. But the one that was needed was busy in the bush. Hola kula sikeporia. That God chose for America. Even now, in the name of Jesus, let not human knowledge, let's pray, Lord, in the election of 2016, I pray, Lord Jesus, that you know, if none of them is qualified, throw them out and bring your own David. Give us a David for America, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, our God, in Jesus' name we are praying. We are hearing so much of recession in Nigeria. Let's pray for Nigeria, Lord. Help Buhari, oh Lord. Help this government, Lord. Help them, give them wisdom. All these stealing, manipulations, and all kind, put an end to it. Let us pray. Let's pray for our own country. Father, in the name of Jesus, many of us on this line are Nigerian, and we call upon you tonight that you will help our nation. Help the president. Bring us out of recession. Bring us out of recession in the mighty name of Jesus. Out of austerity pressure. All those who are stealing. All those who are making boast that they can do everything. This water is my own. This nation is my own. Frustrate them, O God. Remove them, O God. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, our God. In Jesus' name we are praying. I want you to pray for yourself tonight as we close. One more time, prophesy to yourself. Tell yourself, I will get there. Hallelujah. Paul said, I will get there. He said, I don't behave as if I've apprehended. But one thing I do, I press forward because I know I will get there. And he got there. He said, a crown is waiting for me. There is a crown of joy waiting for you. There is a crown of success waiting for you. There is a crown that only God gives. I will get there. My life will no more be wasted. My destiny will no more be wasted. Whatever it will take for me to press on, Lord, give me grace, Lord. I will make it. In this country, I will make it. Breakthrough is my portion. Prosperity is my portion. New life is my portion. Ministerial advancement, ministerial glory, ministerial progress is my portion, Lord. My wife will not die. My children will not die. My children shall succeed. My ministry shall be global in the name of Jesus. Good health is my portion. Sickness is not my portion. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Shakondo Robo Shuria. Thank you, mighty God. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. You know, the last prayer I want to pray for you as we close, thank you, God, for your life, is in a popular verse, Romans 8, verse 26. It says, likewise, the Spirit also helps our infirmity. As you go tonight, I prophesy to you, the Holy Ghost will help you. As you transit from this month to a new month, the Holy Ghost will help your infirmity. Whatever is considered infirmity, financial infirmity, physical infirmity, academic infirmity, matrimonial infirmity, Malike Posokoria, I ask God to help your infirmity, to break you in the name of Jesus. You shall make it. You shall not fall by the wayside. Your life will not be moribund. I remove obstacle. I remove financial constraint in the name of Jesus. You will have money to spend. Good health is your portion in the name of Jesus. Your marriage will not go to waste in the name of Jesus Christ. God will assist you. God will assist you. God will assist you. God will assist you. Go and succeed. Your children will succeed. Your husband will succeed. You yourself will succeed. Your career will succeed. Your marriage will succeed. Whatever you lay your hands on shall prosper. I said to you, you will not die young. You will not bury me suddenly. I will not bury you suddenly. You will not become a widow. You will not become a widower. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, thank you, Holy Ghost. Go and prosper. Sleep well. Wake up well. As you work hard, God will reward you. As you win soul, God will reward you. As you give, God will reward you. As you pray, God will reward you. Heaven shall open for you in the name of Jesus. Thank you for the new baby you have given us. I declare to that child, you will be one of those ones that will change this world for better. In the name of Jesus, you will be outstanding. You will stand out. We use you as point of contact for those who are on this line and say, God, let me carry my womb. Let me carry my baby. Carry your baby. By this time next month, you will carry your pregnancy in the mighty name of Jesus. By this time next year, you will carry your baby. You will give your testimony in the name of Jesus. Thank you, our God. In Jesus' precious name we are prayed. Amen. Amen. Amen in Jesus' name. God bless you in Jesus' name. Please make sure you are on the line. There will be other coordinators while we have traveled. And it is not about Dada, it's about you. Amen. It is about you calling on God. This is do it yourself. This is about praying yourself. Invite others to come. Invite others to join. There is power in prayer. The prayer that God will not answer is the prayer that has not been said. Encourage yourself to pray. It is better for us to pray together. It's easier for us to pray together. Don't miss this prayer line. God is doing wonders beyond what we know, beyond what we see. Even your people that you are talking and praying for, they are giving testimonies. And the Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. Good night and God bless. For those who may be watching this on Periscope or YouTube, I want you to know that this pastor, Amos Dada, and by the grace of God, the senior pastor of Christ Apostolic Church, Bethel Toronto, we worship here at 94 Kenhardt Drive, Suite 22, Toronto, Ontario, M9L192. And we just want to invite you to come. I love praying because I love God and I see results. You know, one thing is about God. It's a result-oriented God. If we just say, let there be light and there will be light. And he says we are made in his own image. In the image whereby we can proclaim, we can declare, we can prophesy, and things begin to happen. I want you to make yourself a prayer warrior. I want you to see the results of prayer. We are engaging people and teaching people. Listen, there's something God has put in my heart that we have just started. It's called Eagle Academy. In Eagle Academy, which is a trainer model program, it's 3-month module. We are taking people now for for the fall of 2016. And you can apply when you watch this television, you know, write to cacigoacademy@gmail.com and then request for form, and the registrar will get in touch with you and you'll be part of. One of the things we teach here is intercession, is how to pray. We teach integrity. We teach missions. We teach the core things that will help you. You know, the sermon on the month, fundamentals of the Christian faith. I want us to be part of it. And if you are not going to church, my sister, my brother, you are wasting away. You need to go to a Bible-believing church near to you. You don't need to come to Bethel alone. Amen. There are many Bible-believing churches. Go there, but make sure you are not wasting away. Press on. The Lord spoke to us tonight about pressing on. That trouble you are facing has an end. Yeah, I can tell you. He has an expiry date. Did you see anybody making any material that has no, even warranty? They will tell you 1 year warranty, meaning that after that one, anything can happen. Hallelujah. Your life will be blessed. Thank God for watching. And the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Good night. In Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you.